The possibilities with him in Kentucky are boundless. There's hemp creek, hemp wood, burlap. So many products can be made from him. And there's a pioneer in here. I've asked her to speak. Katie Moyer is somewhere. She's going to tell you what's going on in the hemp industry in Kentucky and where we're going to go from here on out. Katie, if you would come up and address the folks, I'd appreciate it. Katie's been doing this from day one in hemp.
So we kind of addressed them to the point that, you know, it's something that the feds have to do. government, the General Assembly's way of saying, you know, you've got to label it right, you've got to make sure that you have an address on there and a zip code and a way for people to contact you. Because we've had people sell CBD out there that don't even have a phone number or a website. They call us, and then they yell at us, and we're like, no, no, you know, our number's on everything. So it's very important. I hope that that bill will continue, and from what I hear, I got an update from Representative Graves this morning, and it should be posted for Health and Family Services Committee tomorrow. It just kind of slowed down for a little bit, but it's looking like we're going to get a hearing. The last bill for the year, was what we've been calling the Safe Lithium Farmers Act. This is House Bill 506, and it was really put in sort of as a last-ditch effort to get some conversation going about smokable flower, smokable hemp flower, this session. And we, you know, I hesitate to use the term smokable flower because when I think about what legalizing hemp flower means to me and my company and my family and my friends is hemp salad, hemp microgreens, hemp leaves in my smoothies, CBDA, THCA, all of those good acids and all those good nutrients that comes from the leaves of the plant. So it's been said that hemp is marijuana's sober cousin. And I think that's an okay description, but I also, personally, marijuana's dietitian. Hemp is the one saying you've got to eat your hemp seeds and you've got to get your fiber and don't forget that protein. Let's get you some fresh acids, amino acids, all this good stuff that we need for good brain health and good cardiovascular function. And I've always said that hemp is a way for us to get to a point where maybe our health and our diet is so good that we don't even have to use medical marijuana. I would love to get the American diet to the point where diabetes isn't a thing anymore. And these you know, chronic illnesses, chronic pain, a lot of these things are managed by the food that we eat. And a lot of people who have the best results with cannabis that I found, and I'm sure a lot of you all have found, are the ones who change their diet as well. So I think I will wrap things up, but I just kind of want to end with, you know, judging by how kind of panicky everybody is about smokable flower and the possibility that hemp flower might be in someone's car or you know, looking like marijuana or something like that, they're so scared of it.